with Quick WordPress, and today I'm going to teach you how to install things in WordPress using XAMPP. That means you are hosting it locally. Okay, so without my talking, let's dive into it. So let's go to wordpress.org. That is the official website for WordPress. So this is how the site looks like. Okay, so we go to themes. You have to download some themes. Okay, so let's download this Mosso theme. So download this one, and I think we should download a different one too. Okay, so let's download this one too. Okay, so left for some minute for some small seconds for, yeah, so it's done, right? So let's look at where it was downloaded to. So this is what we downloaded, okay, and we are going to install it. So this is what you do. You go to appearance, then you go to themes. Okay, so themes. So these are the only themes that we have, these three themes, and we've downloaded I think two themes here. Yeah, we have one graduate and we have the Mosso theme. So let's install. We have so many ways of doing this, so many ways. You can go to add themes, add new. Yeah, add new. So when you go to add new, and in a WordPress itself, you can install it straight for it. So all you need is some data and other stuff. But normally, if you are installing or you are using the WordPress locally on your using XAMPP on your computer, sometimes you can access these themes to install. So this is what you do. You go to upload themes. After downloading the theme that you want to use, so upload theme, you go to browse, then you choose where. So this is the theme that we want to install. So yeah, you can see over here. Okay, so it's unpacking, it's installing the theme is successfully installed. But I think it should give us some error messages. It's not done, so let's check the error messages. As for the theme, it has been installed, because I have to update my theme. Yeah, I have the 13 updater I have to do. Okay, see, warning, unexpected error occurred. Something may be wrong with the WordPress.org. Okay, so we go to theme to see whether our theme has been installed and we can use it. Okay, so this is what we have. At first, we had only these three things, 1, 2, 3. So this is what we have, and let's just activate it and view it. So I'll show you another way of installing it when it gives you some errors and other stuff. Okay, so let's view it. Oh wow. Okay, so as you can see, our theme, we have installed our new theme that we can add some changes to it and use it. Okay, so let me show you another way of installing things. Okay, so this is what we do. You go to my computer, go to my computer, you go to drive C. So you find our exam folder and we go to htdocs. From htdocs we look for our WordPress, and mind you, I'm using WordPress 1 because I have so many WordPress, I have so many WordPress that I've been using, and I've been using to build my blogs and do learn more things about WordPress and other stuff. Yeah, so this is where you go. You go to the WordPress 1 because I'm using the WordPress 1. So WordPress 1, you go to content, you go to things, and as you can see we have our muscle theme over here, and we have the three themes. Okay, so this is what you do. Go to downloads, that is where we downloaded our theme. So the graduate theme is over here, so you just copy it and you paste it here. So then you extract it, so you have to extract it here. So there's no need for you to install it, go into the WordPress and do all those things. So you just extract it and you are done, finished. You can even delete this one because you don't need it. You just, okay, so after extracting it you can delete it. So we will not use it again, so we can delete it. So we have it over here, and let's go and view it. We go to plugins, themes, so appearance and themes. Okay, so as you can see we have it over here. We have the graduate theme over here, and let's view it and see how it looks like. Okay, woo, this is how it looks like. Everything cool, huh? Yeah, it's very very cool. Okay, so thank you for watching, and don't forget to subscribe and click on that small bell so that anytime I upload a new tutorial you will never miss it. Thank you.